the number one thing that I cannot stress to everybody is lighting. If you don't have lighting, don't even bother. Don't waste your time, don't waste your battery, just don't bother. I like a really sort of warm yellow light, or if you've got a window, like put like a curtain or a t-shirt in front of it, and then sort of get like more of a diffused light instead of a hard light. A hard light can sort of wash off the makeup, wash off the color on your face. Generally, when you're taking a selfie, you want the light to be coming from behind the camera. So let's say this is my phone, you want the light to be coming from here. Sometimes backlit photos actually look really good as well, but most of the time, you want to be taking it from here. Sort of get your hair right. Avoid getting your underarm and stuff in it as well. Like, I like to stretch the neck up really, really high. It looks weird, but it photographs really well. And then point the chin down. But another thing that I find is, sometimes when you're taking a few selfies and it's been a few minutes, you start to get like these weird stare like in your eyes. So it's always important to like sort of look down, refocus your eye, and then look at the camera. I like to get the side angle of my face as well, so it looks angular and skinny, obviously. Haters will say that's photoshopped. I have not even touched that yet. Okay, so that's another one that I like there. It's just a good angle of the face. The hair is a little bit messy though. It's like 1 degree of difference that can make like the ultimate selfie and the ugliest selfie. It's like literally just moving your face 1 degree and you're gonna get that angle. So